Students will discuss a little bit about the ideal gas equations, the Boyle Charles law and the normal ideal gas equation, because that is used in physics also, though mostly it is used in chemistry, but still we must know about the Boyle Charles law and the ideal gas equation. To start with, we will discuss about Boyle law first. Boyle's law. It says that the volume of a given mass of a gas is inversely proportional to the pressure, keeping the temperature constant. So let me write the statement. The volume of a given mass of a gas is inversely proportional to the pressure of a gas at constant temperature. So two things, if you keep constant, one is the temperature and another is the given mass, this is number of moles. If you keep number of moles and the temperature constant, then volume varies inversely with pressure. If you increase the volume, pressure will decrease and vice versa. Means V is inversely proportional to P and PV is constant. This is Boyle's law. This is Boyle's equation. This is also known as isothermal equation, because isothermal process is that where temperature remains constant. So this is the case where number of moles seem to keep constant. You should not, while increasing the pressure or increasing the volume, the number of moles, the amount of gas that is there should not change. It should not escape from the system, or you should not add more gas into the system. So then only this will vary. The number of moles that of the gas will you have to keep constant, and temperature is not allowed to change under these conditions, these two conditions, fixed conditions. Then only the if you increase the pressure, then volume will decrease. Okay, this is Boyle's law. Now, Charles' law. Charles' law says that the volume of a given mass of a gas is proportional to its absolute temperature. That means the volume will increase. If volume increases, the temperature will also increase. If temperature increases, volume will increase. Provided you keep the pressure and number of moles constant. Now, this is the statement. The volume of a given mass of a gas is proportional to its absolute temperature, provided NPR constant. The number of moles, hence stands for number of moles. It should remain constant. From this, you can get the equation. This is Charles' law. So we have discussed about Charles' law and Boyle's law. Now, what is the ideal gas equation? Ideal gas equation. In ideal gas equation, that this equation is known as ideal gas equation. That means PV equals to nRT. This equation is called ideal gas equation. And here PV equals to nRT, P is the pressure of the gas, V is the volume of the gas, N is the number of moles, R is the universal gas constant, it remains constant for all types of gases, and T is the temperature in absolute scale. In Boyle's law, Charles' law, ideal gas equation, always we have to remember one thing, that the temperature is always expressed in absolute scale. unless expressed in Kelvin, or absolute scale not in degrees centigrade or any other scale. This R is called a universal gas constant, n is the number of moles. Okay. So you can have all types of relation from one equation, that is V is proportional to T if n r p constant. If T is constant, n r constant, then p v is constant. This is Boyle's law. Okay. So from one ideal gas equations, you can also get all other equations. Basically, these are combined to get ideal gas equations. V is proportional to n, p is proportional to n. So we can have other variations of these quantities. Now we will the unit of R also will be, this is if this is in SI system, this will be joule, this is a mole, this is Kelvin, joule per mole Kelvin. This can be the unit. Okay. This is 8.34 something joule per mole Kelvin. In other units also you can express this value of R, but that way, that is not the point of discussion here in this thermal expansion part. In the next video, so this is all about this ideal gas equations, and ideal gas basically means the gas, no gas is actually ideal. But we make all the gases that exist are real gases, but we under certain conditions, those real gases are called ideal gas. That means if you at low enough densities and very high temperature, very high temperature, low enough density, that means a low pressure, the real gas approaches ideal behavior. Okay, real gas approaches ideal behavior of a gas. Therefore, these gases are called ideal gases. That means if you think about oxygen or any other carbon dioxide or any other gas, they are all real gases. But then if you keep on decreasing the pressure or the density and increase the temperature, so it will follow, it will move towards the ideal behavior of the gases, low enough densities. Okay. Thank you.